Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss about matrices. First of all, let's define a matrix. A matrix whose plural is matrices is any array of real numbers or some other suitable entities arranged in rows and columns. So basically we say that any rectangular array of numbers is called a matrix. This is a rectangular array of numbers. This is a matrix. We generally use the large parentheses to identify a matrix, and we can even use brackets for matrix and also double vertical bars are also used in matrix. The horizontal lines of numbers that is these horizontal lines these are called rows, then the vertical lines of numbers, that is, these are the vertical lines of numbers, and these are called columns. Also, each number or entity in a matrix is called an element or entry of the matrix. So if you consider this matrix, the numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 are the elements, or you can say the entries of this matrix. We denote matrix by the capital letters like A, B, C and so on, and the entries, or you can say the elements of matrix, are denoted by small letters A, B, C and so on. So if you consider this matrix, let this be denoted by letter A. Let's now discuss order of a matrix. If a matrix has m rows and n columns, then we say order of the matrix is m by n, or you can say a matrix with m rows, n columns is m by n matrix. While stating the order of a matrix, we first state the number of rows and then the number of columns. If you consider this matrix A with elements 2, 4, 6, 5, 7, 9, then we find that in this matrix A, there are 2 rows three columns. So, order of the matrix A is 2 by 3. That is, we first take the number of rows and then the number of columns. So, we say that this matrix A is a 2 by 3 matrix. Next, we have special types of matrices. First is a row matrix. A matrix having only one row is a row matrix. Consider a matrix B with elements 2, 3, 4. This is a 1 by 3 matrix, that is, it has 1 row and 3 columns. 1 by 3 is the order of this matrix B. As you can see that there is just 1 row in this matrix, so we say that this B, that is the matrix B, is a row matrix. Next is column matrix. A matrix having only one column is a column matrix. Consider a matrix C with elements 2, 3, 4. This is a 3 by 1 matrix, that is, there are 3 rows and 1 column. Now, as there is only 1 column in this matrix, so we say that this matrix C is a column matrix. Next, square matrix. A matrix having same number of rows and columns is called a square matrix. Consider a matrix D with elements 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, this is a 2 by 2 matrix, that is, there are 2 rows and 2 columns in this matrix, which means that the number of rows and the number of columns in this matrix are equal. So, this is a square matrix. Now, as the number of rows and number of columns for this square matrix D is 2, so we can also denote this as D2, which means that in this square matrix, the number of rows and number of columns are 2. Next, we have a zero matrix. A matrix with all elements 0 is called a zero matrix or a null matrix. A zero or null matrix is generally denoted by O. Now consider a 2 by 3 zero matrix, that is in which we have 2 rows and 3 columns. In this matrix, all the elements are zero. So this is a null matrix or a zero matrix. Next we have diagonal matrix. A square matrix with all elements 0 except the principal diagonal elements is called a diagonal matrix. For example, consider a matrix X of 3 by 3 order in which the elements are 3, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 4. This is a 3 by 3 matrix. Now the principal diagonal means the diagonal from the top left to the top bottom. So this shaded is the principal diagonal whose elements are 3, 1, 4. As in this matrix X, which is a square matrix, all the elements are 0 except these principal diagonal elements. These principal diagonal elements, some of these diagonal elements can be 0, but all of them cannot be 0. Next we have a unit matrix. Or identity matrix. A square matrix with each diagonal element as unity and all other elements as zero is called a unit matrix or identity matrix. A unit matrix of order n is denoted by IN. Like if you have I2, this is a unit matrix of order 2, that is we have 2 rows and 2 columns in this and it has elements 1, 1 in the diagonal and rest of the elements are 0. Let's now discuss the general form of a matrix. Say a matrix A. Now, the general form of this matrix is given by Aij of order n by n, or we can simply write this as a matrix with elements Aij. We have order of the matrix A is m by n, that is m is the number of rows, n is the number of columns. This element Aij of the matrix, it belongs to the ith row and the jth column, and this is called the ijth element of the matrix A. And in this element Aij of the matrix A, the subscript I, it represents the row number, and the subscript j represents the column number. So the element, say A12, means that this element belongs to the first row and second column. That is, 1 represents the row number and 2 represents the column number. We can also write the general form of the matrix A as the matrix with elements in the first row as A11, A12, A13, and so on up to A1n, since we have n number of columns in the matrix A. Then the elements in the second row are given by A21, A22, A23, and so on up to A2n. In the same way, we will proceed for the rest of the rows. As there are m rows in the matrix A, so the last row of the matrix A could be given as A, M1, A, M2, A, M3, and so on up to A, MN. So this is the matrix A of order M by N. That is, there are M rows and N columns. Now suppose, consider a matrix B with elements in the first row as 6, 2, in the second row as 3, minus 1, and in the third row as 0, 5. So this matrix B is of order 3 by 2, that is, there are 3 rows and 2 columns. Now in this, the element 6 is A11, that is, in the first row and the first column. Then element 2 is A12, that is the element appearing in the first row and the second column. Then A21 is the element appearing in the second row and first column, which is 3. A22 is the element appearing in the second row and second column, and this is minus 1. Then A31 is the element appearing in the third row and first column, and this is 0. Then A32 is the element appearing in the third row and second column, which is 5. Next, we discuss the equality of matrices. Two matrices are equal if and only if they satisfy the two conditions, that is, both matrices are of the same order and their corresponding elements are equal. Consider a matrix A with elements in the first row as 2, 1, 0 and in the second row the elements are 3, 2, 1. Also, consider a matrix B with elements in the first row as 6 by 3, 3 by 3, 0 by 3. In the second row, the elements are 3, 4 minus 2 and 2 minus 1. Now both the matrices A and B are of order 2 by 3. So they satisfy the first condition, that is both the matrices should be of same order. Now let's see if the corresponding elements are equal. Now 2 is equivalent to 6 by 3, 1 is equivalent to 3 by 3, 0 is equivalent to 0 by 3, 3 is equivalent to 3, this 2 is equivalent to 4 minus 2 and 1 is equivalent to 2 minus 1. So the corresponding elements are also equal. This means that the matrices A and B are equal. Now let's consider a matrix C with elements in the first row as 2, 1. In the second row, the elements be 3, 4. Now consider a matrix D with elements in the first row as 1, 2. In the second row as 4, 3. Now the matrices C and D both are of order 2 by 2, but the corresponding elements are not equal. So they do not satisfy both the conditions of equality of matrices. So this means the matrix C is not equal to the matrix D. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the concept of matrices and the special types of matrices.